Hi friends, endometritis is a frequent problem for the equine breeders, for the equine clinicians and those practicing the equine medicine. Now, endometritis is of two types. The one is the mating induced endometritis, which occurs after a mating. There is plenty of fluid accumulation in the uterus and that prevents the pregnancy to be established. The second one is the clinical endometritis, and mares with clinical endometritis frequently fail to conceive. The incidence of endometritis may vary from 25 to even sometimes up to 60%, and mares with endometritis have logical problems of conception, and they frequently show signs of discomfort, abdominal pain and sometimes lameness of the hind legs. Now endometritis, mating induced endometritis can occur because of the mating and the voluminous amount of semen that is deposited in the equine uterus. And in aged mares, when the lacteals that drain out, this fluid accumulated inside the uterus, the mating induced endometritis, it occurs. There is frequent accumulation of fluid within the uterus, and clinicians often face this problem while performing pregnancy diagnosis, and they find that there is fluid accumulation in the uterus. This type of endometritis may occur in the mare, and many a times the fluid is aseptic, and the only therapy that is required is administration of an ecbolic like oxytocin. Some clinicians also suggest the uterine lavage or administration of N-acetylcysteine 3% or DMSO 30% or 1% hydrogen peroxide. Then the clinical endometritis, mares with clinical endometritis may be having problem in conception, and the causative organism for clinical endometritis could be E. coli or Streptococcus zooidemicus or maybe other types of microbes. The diagnosis of endometritis is based on the transrectal palpation of fluid accumulation in the uterus, transrectal ultrasonographic visualization of the fluid accumulated in the uterus, and uterine sample sent for the microbiology lab for organism evaluation and the sensitivity test. Now, for sensitivity test and for collection of samples from the uterus, you need a special double barrel gun, and these should be used for sample collection for the organism identification and the sensitivity test. Then the mare should be treated accordingly, and the most appropriate treatment suggested by many is the uterine lavage by introducing a long polycatheter inside the uterus, fixing it, and then attaching a bottle of normal saline or maybe Ringer's lactate, and then that is going inside and coming out, and once the effluent is clear, then this infusion is stopped. Then intrauterine administration of antibiotics can be practiced, and one can use a wide variety of antibiotics, but it is suggested to use them judiciously, because otherwise biofilm forming organisms may become insensitive to the infusion of the antibiotics. For intrauterine infusion of the medicine, the mare is secured properly, tail is bandaged, and the perineum is washed and sterilized, and then the clinician wears a sleeve, sterile sleeve, and introduces a long catheter inside the uterus by guiding it through the vagina and introducing it in up to the level of the uterus. Once it is inside the uterus, then you can infuse the medicine inside. And then alternatives to this could be the administration of mucolytics like N-acetylcysteine, the administration of dimethyl sulfoxide, and likewise other things. So endometritis can be problematic, but one should also look in for other problems. Maybe there are problems of the conformation of the perineum or the vulvar lips, and they should, that should be treated on the priority, right? So kindly, if you like this video, kindly share it, kindly subscribe to my channel. If you want, I should make more videos. Kindly do not forget to hit the subscribe button and give your comments, likes and shares. Right? Bye-bye.